Welcome to the live stream. Thank you for being our first guest of the evening.
We already got some questions from everyone for you.
That is fantastic.
I want to make note, Jeffrey, the last time we saw you was at SeaWorld Orlando and you were absolutely drenched
from
Mako night rides. I'd love if you could talk about that because I believe you were on the opposite train as us, just marathoning, doing the exact same thing we were.
Which is hysterical because we literally did not get off Mako for over 2 hours.
I love
After
that.
We
oh
got
my
30
gosh.
Consecutive rides, we just stopped counting. But oh my gosh, what a fantastic ride. So much fun and just crazy silly. But it was unbelievable that we never ran into you guys until literally we all got off.
I know. That was crazy. I mean, that's what happens. You're just on the opposite train, so you have no idea who else is there. So yeah, that is so funny. So so we know who you are. We've hung out plenty of times. But for those who are tuning in, I'd love if you could just kind of give a little introduction for yourself.
Well, hello to everybody and good evening. And thank you guys so much for the invitation and doing it for a great, great cause. We love Give Kids the World Village and obviously all that you guys do at Coaster Studios. But for those that I have not met or have not been to Six Flags Fiesta, Texas yet, I am the park president for Six Flags Fiesta, Texas in beautiful San Antonio. And also Hurricane Harbor Splash Town, which is in spring, just a little bit north of downtown Houston. And I've been doing this craziness now since 1994, working for a variety of different parks and companies before working my way to the great state of Texas and eventually to Six Flags Fiesta, Texas.
Well, that's awesome. You've had an incredible impact in the industry. And I'd also like to point out that you're just like the rest of us. You're a total coaster enthusiast.
Such
I think that is awesome.
I am officially a card-carrying member, as you know, since 1991.
Wow.
That was before either of us were alive.
We were not alive. That is incredible. So I got to ask, is this something that you always wanted to get into? Did you know that you wanted to, make roller coasters and theme parks your passion for life?
Absolutely. From my earliest memories, I grew up in Cleveland, Ohio, and my parents, when they first got engaged and married, they lived right outside of a park that no longer exists called Euclid Beach. And theme parks and amusement parks are just part of their DNA. So growing up, every year we went to Cedar Point and Geauga Lake and SeaWorld of Ohio and then Conneaut Lake and Kennywood and you name it. We did a fun tour of duty every single summer. And I used to pretend that my backyard was an amusement park and wagons were roller coasters. And I just have always known that this is what I wanted to do.
Well, that is so cool. And I think I think there's a lot of people here in the community that can relate to that.
Mm-hmm.
And I think this is so cool and really, really inspiring. It shows that, you know, if you work hard and try hard enough that, you know, you can absolutely like make it. I mean, you've really worked your way up. You've worked at a lot of different places. I mean, if you go back and watch some old footage, I mean, you can see you got to do the big announcement for some rides at Kings Island. You were involved with like Tomb Raider and like Son of Beast. And that is like the craziest thing to me.
We got $100 donation from Sean Flaherty and Kyle. Oh, I know.
Kyle Cruthifer.
Okay. I didn't know how to say that. I'm like, I know Kyle. He said, he wanted us to tell you, the world's most heavily themed, totally immersive dark ride adventure, Tomb Raider the Ride. That's from them.
lots of great memories there for sure.
Well, and also the thing, something that I found out about not that long ago, I didn't realize you were the voice for the Beast.
Yeah, that was great to find out.
That is correct. If you go up the lift hill, you will hear something mysterious that sounds a lot like me. This is a true classic. Again, the Beast and the love and passion that went into designing that ride with Al Collins and Jeff Gramke. It's one of those attractions that truly can never be replicated anywhere on planet Earth. It's just a true masterpiece that's fun to experience today.
That is so cool. So I wanted to talk about, so you guys are building a big new ride right now, and that is Dr. Diabolical. And, you know, a lot of people are familiar with this ride from what has been announced. But, you know, we got to talk a little bit at IAPA about this ride, and some of the things that you were talking about with us just got me so much more excited about this. I'd love if you could kind of explain, like, what makes this different from the other dive coasters that have been built in the U.S.? Because I think that our audience would really appreciate that.
There is, and as you kind of alluded to earlier, being a coaster enthusiast myself, it was lots of fun to work with our friends at B&M, Sophie and Kim and Alberto, and really along with our corporate engineering team and others, really design a dive coaster that feels different from other dive coasters. And part of it was going 95 degrees, the first B&M on planet Earth to go beyond vertical, and reimagining all the elements and features so that the ride's pacing really becomes an important part of the overall experience and excitement. So the Emelman is definitely intense. The zero-G barrel roll is a deviant, which means it's not a traditional zero-G barrel roll. It's more in line with, for example, what you'd experience in our Iron Rattler to create a really cool, powerful, but yet floating sensation. Then we pulled down turns and curves and made vertical acceleration stronger and more impactful. So as you go through the ride, the forces actually intensify and are exaggerated more the further you go along. So believe it or not, the strongest airtime moment, which traditionally is actually on the first drop of the ride, our strongest airtime moment is the very last bunny hop before you go into the high-speed spiral.
That's so cool.
G-force, or the highest vertical acceleration, is actually that turn. It's that spiral. So you go from the greatest negative G-load and then within seconds to the highest G-load to really create some fun dynamics. And then we even designed a small additional airtime pop into the brake run. So even as you hit that brake run transition on those mag brakes, you're going to get another fun airtime moment at the ride's finale. So we really try to make sure that every single inch of the ride performs in very exciting, fun ways, including we actually redesigned the train a little bit.
Yeah.
The train can fold in and bend in itself and articulate those maneuverabilities faster and tighter than any other dive coaster to date. And it features another rare amenity that typically you can't do anywhere else on planet Earth, and that's a true center seat. We get lots of questions of why the heck would you have picked a seven-seat train? Well, two reasons, again, being the enthusiast in me. One is it's wider. It's the widest train that you can do on this track configuration, so the train just looks visually stunning. Mm-hmm. But also it does afford where you can actually ride truly in the center of the rail, which, as you know, there's only a handful of coasters on planet Earth that you can truly get a center seat ride. And now we're a park that happens to have two of those. Our beloved Wonder Woman attraction, you can ride truly in the center because it is single rail. But this is the first of its kind where you can also ride truly in the center to get that dynamic.
That is awesome. So one of the questions that was donated is, we want to know, how did the idea of the theme for Dr. Diabolical's Cliffhanger come to be?
Well, a lot of it was research from our guests. We know that our guests love steampunk, and our crack axle canyon area, instead of looking like an old Western town, as you know, we've been reimagining it into more of a steampunk, timeless look. And so we did a lot of research with our guests and spoke with thousands of folks. Believe it or not, even the name Dr. Diabolical's Cliffhanger was selected by our guests. The pink color on the ride was selected by our guests. The overall ideas and story are all from our guests. And even when we're doing our retail, one of the fun retail things that we have is a shirt and a whole product line that basically reads, "Trust me, I'm a doctor." And all of those types of things are really selected and picked by our guests.
Well, that's awesome. I love that you guys take everybody's ideas into consideration. Like, it's really awesome how much you guys really love and value your guests. Now, on a kind of different subject, somebody wanted to know, what has been your favorite new attraction you've ever been a part of? And now we know you've worked at a lot of different places, so that might be a tricky question, but try your best.
Well, I would say probably the most excited that I was, just because of all that was in it, was Tomb Raider the ride. Anyone that remembers that ride, it was just truly a unique time in itself, with the branding and excitement of the storyline, all the thematical props from Pinewood Studios and the movie itself, all the way down to the Range Rover. There was just lots of love and attention that went into creating that totally immersive dark ride adventure, which really became a fun experience for those that got to ride it. In more modern history, no doubt I would say the ride that has performed the best and most loved immediately has been Iron Rattler. Iron Rattler, truly, when it opened in 2013, was an immediate hit and has elevated the park experience from day one. It just hit on all cylinders, which has been really fun. And we have so much here to be thankful for with how well that has been received by our guests and how thrilling and fun. And it's even harder to believe that we're getting very close to the 10th anniversary of the Iron Rattler already. But as far as anticipated excitement, no doubt Cliffhanger is one of those game-changing moments where we're able to build a giant, big, fun, tall, exciting coaster, something that our guests have never seen anywhere thousands of miles of us. So it's just going to look so visually different. And the storytelling and theming that we're putting on it really is going to be another very special moment, and hopefully truly another catapult and catalyst to continue the forward momentum of Six Flags Fiesta Texas.
That's absolutely a great answer. Yeah. I never thought I'd be excited for a dive coaster, but here I am. I'm like, I hear you talk, and I'm like, I'm psyched. I'm sold.
No.
Like, I'm flying to Texas to ride a dive coaster. I'm excited.
Absolutely.
So just a couple more questions. We have a little bit of time left, right? Yeah, we do.
Yeah.
Perfect. So somebody asked, what kind of background do you have to have to become a park president like yourself? Like, if you have any advice for someone who's aspiring to do something similar.
Well, there's all kinds of things. There's different ways to get here. My path was more from the business and marketing side. Many of my counterparts actually came from the finance side of the business, and yet others came from the operational side. So there's different ways. It really goes back to the skill set and passion to do the right thing, have fun along the way, and really just take care of people. And those folks that make it typically to this level of an organization really are just that. They're focused on guests, our team, our shareholders, and most importantly, just want to have fun along the way. But my background really was on the business marketing side. And I did internships at Jack Rouse and Associates, which just merged with RWS Entertainment. And they do and design theme parks. And we're designing theme parks back in the day as well. And many of those folks came from Kings Island and Taft Broadcasting. So I've always had a fun ride. But hopefully that gives a little bit more background in different ways that you could eventually become a park president as well.
Wow.
That's a great answer.
Yeah. That's awesome.
And then I'm not going to tell you who wrote this because I'm guessing you'll know. What coaster enthusiast wears the best hat to amusement parks?
Where's the best what?
The best hat. Do you know Clint Novak?
Yes, I know Clint. What is he wants to know the best cap?
Hat. Like,
who wears the best? It's
which he wants you to say that he wears the best hat.
Because he wears the stinking pinwheel hat.
Oh, for God's sakes, Clint, you always look amazing, my friend.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
He is a true fashion plate.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that is great. We were so thankful to have you be a part of This Is How We Roll, which is the big documentary that we debuted about Rocky Mountain construction. I just want to ask, did you have any idea what you were getting yourself into when we asked if we could interview you for this thing?
Well, when it comes to you two, yes, I have a pretty good idea what the heck I'm getting into, and more importantly, just happy to help any way that we can. It's exciting to share the history and legacy of our different suppliers, manufacturers that bring the magic to our guests and ourselves every single day. It's always fun to be a part of what you guys have, and just like when you reached out for this, any way that I can help pay the information forward and continue to offer insights for the next generation of theme park enthusiasts and operators, count me in. Glad to help.
You are literally my favorite person, like, ever.
And we're not just that. Like,
I feel like we say this, like, fairly often. We're just like, Jeff Siebert, like, that guy is amazing.
Kid you not, like, every time, like, we talk to you, I just have, like, the biggest smile. I just feel good about myself.
I feel good about everything. And I want you to know that we have gone up to $1,300 since you got on here. So I'm sure a huge portion of that is thanks to you. So thank you so much.
So we will let you go, but
my pleasure. And I just love all the good that you guys are doing, your passion and excitement, and look forward to seeing where the adventures take you both next.
Well, thank you so much.
Hopefully
it brings us to Six Flags Fiesta, Texas for Dr. Diabolical.
That's the plan.
We will for sure see you there next year. We can't wait.
It absolutely better, my friends. I would be extremely disappointed if I didn't see your smiling faces riding and we could all just have fun and enjoy what this really is all about, which is just hanging out with great people, having fun, and it's the rides that unite us, but it's the friendships that keep us coming back over and over again.
Jeffrey.
We love you.
He needs to write a theme park Bible.
I know. Can you write a book one day?
Please.
All right. Well, thank you so much, my friend. We'll see you soon.
Oh my gosh. Happy holidays. Merry Christmas, and look forward to seeing everyone around the park.
You too. All right. Bye. Thank you.